Hi folks, the word of God, John chapter 4. Right. Yeah? It's my Quran, bro. What? It's my Quran, bro. You got a Quran? I got a Quran. Who says that? Show me in the Quran where it says I cannot have a Quran.
No, I don't say that.
Show me in the Quran where it says I cannot have a Quran.
No, I didn't say that. I said you only carry in the Quran. Why is that?
I carry in my Bible.
Yeah, I know, but do you have another Bible?
Yeah. Are you a Muslim?
No.
What are you?
Chinese.
Good. Guess what? I'm Japanese then. If you're Chinese, I'm Japanese. All right? It says, John chapter 4 verse 20, our fathers worshipped in the mountain, and you say that in Jerusalem is the place where men ought to worship. And Jesus said unto her, woman, believe me, the hour cometh when you shall neither in the mountain nor yet at Jerusalem worship the Father. You worship you know not what, we know what we worship, for salvation is of the Jews. The Jews. Not Islam, but the Jews. For the hour cometh, and now is, when the true worshippers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such, worship him. God is spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and truth. Do you agree with that, sir? Sir, do you agree with that? The words of Jesus. You must worship in spirit and truth. In the Holy Spirit, Jesus said to Nicodemus, He said, are you ready now? He said, you must be born again. Born again of the Holy Ghost. You need to be born again of the Holy Spirit and not be religious. Religion is not what Jesus came to set up. Religion is dead men's bones. The Pharisees were arguing all the time, and they were bringing in new laws. You Muslims are always arguing, and you bring in Sharia law, and Jesus said you must be born again. Born again of the Holy Ghost. Now the Bible says there is a hell. There is a hell. God is going to bring judgment, and hell is coming.
Allah!
Oh, donkey boy.
Allah!
How you doing, donkey man? Come here, bro. Come here.
Allah!
God bless you, man. God bless you.
Allah!
I've got a song for Uncle Jamal. Uncle Jamal.
Allah!
Uncle Jamal. I'll go and waltzing with Uncle Jamal.
Do some word you want.
I'll heckle the Christians every night. Uncle Jamal, I'll go a heckling with Uncle Jamal. I'll heckle in the morning. Jamal, I'll go a waltzing with Uncle Jamal. God bless you, bro. I love you, man. Yeah? Jesus died for you on that cross. He died on that cross. And there is a hell. There is a hell. Uncle Jamal, give me a hug. Come on, bro. I love you, man. You're my man. Don't leave me, bro. Don't leave me, Uncle Jamal. Uncle Jamal, don't leave me. Don't leave me, bro. I need you, bro. Uncle Jamal, God bless you, man. Give me five, man. Uncle Jamal, give me five, man. God bless you. Now, there is a hell. Jesus said there'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth. There is a judgment to come. And God will judge. He will judge. And there is a hell and a judgment to come. And if you want to escape hell, how do you escape hell? Do you know? How do you escape hell? How do you escape hell as a Muslim? How? Jesus said there'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth in hell. Now, have you ever lied, sir? Have you ever lied? Have you ever lied, sir? Have you ever lied? Yeah? What is God going to do with liars? He's going to send them to hell. But Jesus died on your behalf. Jesus died on your behalf to save you. Save you and bring you home to life and power and joy. But there's no power in religion. There's no power in laws. There's no power in a false prophet. But there's power in Jesus. Power in Him. Power in the Lord. Power in the King. Power in Christ. Life. Enjoy. You come, bro. You come. I'm waiting for you, bro. I'm coming. You come, bro. I'm waiting for you, bro. I'm waiting for you. Come on, bro. I'm waiting. Bring what you got, bro. Come on. Come on. Come on. As Bruce Lee would say, come. I'm waiting for you, bro. Jesus came to save you, King. Jesus came to save you from hell and give you new life. But you're addicted to Paul. Have you been looking at Paul? I say, have you been looking at Paul? Yeah. Have you been looking at Paul? Have you been looking at Paul? Have you been looking at Paul? Look me in the eye, bro. Have you been looking at Paul? Hey! 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 Have you been looking at Paul? Have you been looking at Paul? If you've been looking at Paul, you're bad in hell! Have you been sleeping with your girlfriend? Have you been playing around with your girlfriend? Because if you've been playing around with your girlfriend, there is fire in hell! Have you been lying? Have you lied to the tax man? Have you kissed your girlfriend and then touched her up? Jesus loves you. He loves you. God bless you. Where are you from? Oh, wonderful place. God bless you. I live in Manchester. If you come to Manchester, you can stay.
Thank you.
God bless you. I know. Okay. Jesus died on a cross for you. Why? To give you life. Religion judges. Religion condemns. The Pharisees judged and they judged and judged and they condemn. They argue. People argue here and they bring religion. They bring Sharia law. But Sharia law cannot save you. Arguments and logic cannot save you. You know what can save you? Jesus, the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. He's over Paul. He's over the nation. He's over Christ. He will give you life and he'll give you victory over pornography. He'll give you victory over masturbation. He'll give you victory in sleeping around. He'll give you victory in smoking. He'll give you victory over your drug taking. Have you been taking drugs? Smoking marijuana? You been smoking marijuana? You're a naughty boy, I'm going to tell your daddy over here, bro. He's been smoking marijuana. Have you got his daddy's phone number? I'm going to phone his daddy up. I'm going to phone your daddy up, bro. Come here now. Where's his daddy's phone number? I'm going to phone your daddy. Here, daddy. He's been smoking marijuana. He's a naughty boy. Call me a naughty boy. Jesus loved you and died for you on that cross. And he wants to give you life. He wants to give you life.
I have a question. Are you a sinner?
Me, sir? You know what I am? I am the chief of sinners. I am the chief of sinners and Jesus died for me and he died for you, bro. And he wants to save you, bro. I am the chief of sinners and yet Jesus died for me. Oh, the deep, deep love of Jesus, vast, unmeasured, boundless, free, rolling as a mighty ocean in its fullness over me. And the love of Christ died for me. And the love of Christ died for you. And Christ shed his blood to save you. And you want to wallow around in porn. You want to wallow around in drugs. You want to wallow around in religion. And argue logical arguments. Oh, we proved those Christians wrong. Ha ha, we got them on the Trinity. No. You need life. You need life. You need spiritual life. You need life in your heart. You need to change and be delivered from your sin. Deliver and have life in you, joy in you, peace. Peace, so you're saved from hell. You're saved from the wrath to come. And you have life in you, and joy in you, and peace in you. And you know the love of God in you. But you're going down the road to hell because you like the porn, you like the drugs, you like the religion, you like the laws and religion, and you like to judge other people. But Jesus said, he said, he is the Lamb. He said this, I am the good shepherd that gives his life for the sheep. And he shed his blood for you. So why will you look at porn? Why will you look at drugs and take drugs? Why will you sleep around? Why will you lie? Why will you fiddle this gospel and lecture? You need Jesus.
I know.
You need his love. Hold his love in his heart for you today. There's love in his heart and peace in his heart. And he wants to give you joy and peace today. Peace and love in your life. Joy in your life. Power in your life. Victory in your life. By the power of the Holy Ghost. By the power of the Holy Spirit. Oh, come out of the religion. Come out of religion and logic and arguments, and come into the power of the Holy Spirit. Come and know the love of Jesus in your life. The love of God in your life. Look at your eyes. You've been smoking. I see it in your eyes. You need life and joy in your heart, brother. Joy of Jesus in your heart. The joy of the Lord in your heart. Oh, there's joy everlasting, power everlasting, eternity to go, a God to be with, because he died for you on that cross, to deliver you on that cross. Oh, come and believe in him. Repent. Don't go for drugs and sex and religion. Repent. Repent or burn in hell, my friend. Burn under the wrath of God. God is a holy God, and he is a consuming fire, and he's a holy God, and he will burn every sin that is in his past, because he's a holy God. But Jesus died on that cross. I am the Lamb of God. I am the Lamb of God, he said. John the Baptist said, behold, the Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. The Lamb died for you. Jesus died on that cross and gave his life for you on that cross. He died for you on that cross to deliver you on that cross from the wrath to come. And he's there for you to believe in him. To believe and trust in him and believe in him and repent and believe. Look, if I give you £50 on your birthday and I give you that £50 as a present, would you take it? If I give you £50 on your birthday, would you take it? God offers you more than £50 today. He offers you eternal life. Don't miss it. Don't miss eternal life. Don't miss eternal life in him. Joy unspeakable and full of glory. Oh, it's wonderful to be a Christian. It's wonderful to be born again. It's wonderful to know the power of God in your heart. To know the Holy Ghost in your heart. It's wonderful. Religion cannot do that. Religion will shrink your heart. Religion will make your heart cold. Religion will make your heart judgmental. Religion will poison you. But Jesus has come to set you free. Jesus has come to give you life. Jesus has come to give you hope and peace. Peace in the heart. Love in your heart. By the power of the Holy Ghost. By the power of Jesus. By the power of God. Oh, the Holy Spirit. To be born again of the Holy Spirit. To be born again of the Holy Ghost. To be born again of Jesus. Do you know Jesus, sir? Do you know Jesus? Are you born again, sir? Are you born again of the Holy Ghost? Are you born again today? Are you born again by the power of the Holy Ghost? Are you born again by the power of Jesus? You need Jesus, my friend. You need Christ as your Savior.
You're making a baby.
Do not mock the word of the Lord, sir. You need Jesus. You need the Lord in your life. And you need him now, today, in your life, sir.
Otherwise, what happens?
Otherwise, it's a consuming fire, sir. You need Jesus. Jesus said, come to me.
I need this.
Jesus said, come to me, all you who are weak and heavy laden, whether you're a Muslim, whether you're Chinese, whether you're Japanese, whoever you are today, you can come to him. You might have been a prostitute all your life, you can come and be forgiven. You might have been on drugs all your life, you can come and be forgiven. You might have been religious all your life, you can come right now and be forgiven. In Romans chapter 1 it says, there is now no condemnation to them that are in Christ. When you believe in Jesus, there's no condemnation. The wrath of God is not on you anymore. You are forgiven and restored and cleansed in the blood of Jesus. So come, come and know his love in your life. Come and know the peace of God in your life. Know the love of God in your life. Come and know the joy of the Lord in your life. He is Lord, he is Lord, he is risen from the dead, and he is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. He is Lord, he is Lord, he is risen from the dead, and he is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Not religion, but life. Not religion, but the Spirit of God. He is Lord, he is Lord, he is risen from the dead, and he is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Will you give your life to Jesus now, sir? Will you give your life to Jesus? God bless you. Will you give your life to Jesus right now? Bow the knee today. Pack in the smoking and believe in Jesus.
Jesus offered his life.
He died and rose again, sir. You need Jesus right now.
If he can't save his life,
sir, you need Jesus right now. You need the life of God right now. If you don't, hell awaits you, sir. Don't go to hell. Don't go to hell, sir. No, please don't go to hell. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Escape hell. Escape hell. Escape the flames of hell. And come to Jesus. Come to the Lord. Come to Jesus. He died on the cross for you, sir. It's better than cigarettes, sir. It's better than that. He loves you. He died for you. Shed his blood for you, sir. Shed his blood for you. Let me ask you a question, sir. Are you a Muslim? I'll become a Muslim right now if you answer this question. Come on, bro. Answer this question. Well, answer it for me, bro. Come on. Here's the question. Did Jesus die on a cross, yes or no? Did Jesus die on a cross, yes or no? Did Jesus die on a cross, yes or no? Yes, no, yes or no? Did Jesus die on a cross, yes or no? Right. You show me as a Muslim right now, here is your Quran. We have your Quran here. It's your Quran. It's my Quran. It's a Jason Burns Quran. It's a Jason Burns edition of the Quran, yeah? Here's the point. In the Quran, if this is the word of God, it will be true. Here is the Bible. Which one is true, the Quran or the Bible? The Quran says that Jesus did not die on the cross. The Quran says that. Bible, sir. Bible, sir. Bible, sir. Bible, sir. Bible says. Bible says he died on the cross. Now which one is true? Quran or Bible? Right. Without the Quran, listen, without the Quran, without the Bible, without the Quran, without the Bible, how do we know which one is true? This is important, because if you're right, I have to become a Muslim. So explain to me how you're right. The Quran says that Jesus did not die on the cross. Did Jesus die on the cross?
No, it said he doesn't.
Okay, right, okay. The Bible says he did, right?
No, in the Quran it says he appeared to them.
Okay, God bless you.
Why lie for?
Now here's the deal, bros. Here's the deal, bros. Are you ready now?
The Quran says
here's the deal. If the Quran is true, I'm coming to mosque on Friday. Alright? So, let's test the Quran if it's true. Says Jesus did not die. Bible says he died. Alright? What evidence do you have right now to convince me Jesus did not die? Come on, bros. I'll give you 10 seconds. One.
What evidence do you have that?
Two. I said three. I said four. I said five. I said six. Come on, you've only got four. I said seven.
The Quran is not disagreeing with you.
I said eight.
You're lying.
I said nine. I said ten. I don't see no evidence.
Say 11, say 11.
Where's your evidence for the Quran saying that Jesus did not die? I'll give you three more seconds. One. Two.
Open the verse. Open the verse.
Oh, he's got. Have you got evidence? You got evidence Jesus did not die. Well, in a minute. Give me some evidence. You're a nice Muslim. Nice to meet you. You're a nice Muslim. Quran says he did not die.
Where? Show us.
It's in the Quran.
Show us.
Got loads of verses.
Show me. Because the Quran says he appeared to them. It doesn't say he didn't die.
That's my paper.
No, I don't read the whole journal.
Can you just read the Quran? Okay. Does the Quran teach? He'll tell us. Does the Quran teach that Jesus did not die?
Yeah.
Does it say he died or not died?
It says he appeared to them.
Okay, thank you. Right, okay. Now,
here's the saying neither.
No. It is Islamic teaching, both Sunni and Shia, that Jesus did not die on the cross. Is that right? You're doing Takiyah now.
Ex-Muslim.
Hey, he's doing, you know what he's doing?
What's the
Takiyah? He's lying.
Takiyah, you're doing Takiyah,
you're lying. Right. I'm going to give this brother here an opportunity to expose me as a liar and show me in the Quran or any historical evidence to prove that Jesus did not die. Where's your Quran? Prove it. No. Well, in a minute. We'll get to that. I just want you to provide evidence that Jesus did not die. If you do that, I'm coming tomorrow. Show me evidence he did not die on the cross. Show me.
Is Jesus dead? Is that what you're trying to say?
Let me give you a one-on-one, right? The Quran says,
show me the verse.
You can Google it. The Quran says, listen. It seemed as if he died. Muslims say he did not die. Right? You got that? He did not die. Paul in Galatians chapter 1 says, cursed is anyone who preaches not the gospel. And the New Testament gospel is, Paul says in 1 Corinthians, we preach Christ crucified. So the Bible teaches that Jesus died. Right?
Right. So what's that?
Wait a minute. No. You don't get out of it now. Give me the historical evidence that Jesus did not die.
Give me the historical evidence Solomon existed. Where's your evidence?
I'll give you the evidence now. Now we go to the Bible.
Historical evidence.
Have I been clear? Have I given the Muslims an opportunity? I have given these lovely, nice Muslim brothers. I have given you lovely opportunities.
I don't want historical evidence.
I have given you lovely opportunity. Opportunity. Listen, listen. I give you opportunity to refute me. Guess what? Guess what? I've been here all day. Listen, listen. I've been here all day. And your top Muslim apologists walk past and they won't debate me.
Who's that?
What's around here? Mickey Mouse. I don't know the names. Well, I know the names, but the top ones. Listen now. Here's my evidence. Historical evidence. Here's my evidence. Josephus Josephus, a Jewish historian, an enemy of Jesus, said that Jesus died under Pontius Pilate. He wrote that about 90 AD. Tacitus, a Roman historian, said that Jesus died under Pontius Pilate. Right? Now, you have enemy attestation against the Bible. So that means Jesus died on the cross. Your Quran, you have no evidence.
Okay, so he died on the cross. Yeah, thousands of people have died on the cross in history. So what? Please, so what? Okay, so he died. There was a man called Jesus Christ. He died on the cross. So what? No. So what? No. Answer my question. So what?
In the Quran, it said Jesus did not die.
No, it doesn't.
They're
saying, indeed, we have killed the Messiah, Jesus, the Son of Mary, the Messenger of Allah. And they did not kill him, nor did they crucify him, but he was made to resemble him over them.
And on these, you prove my argument.
Hang on, it doesn't forget matter if he died or not. Forget. Let's assume he died. Yes. So what?
Let me finish.
So
what? Come on,
so
let
what?
Me finish.
Please, so what?
So what? If you lie, can I trust you if you lie?
No. Go on.
So, that's lying. That says he did not lie.
Said, no, forget about it. Don't start going on about how bad the Quran is or whatever. Just answer me the question. He died on the cross. Maybe there is good, solid, scientific evidence that
we'll
he died.
Come to that.
So what?
We'll come to that in a minute. Let me make my point. The Muslims have not been able to provide evidence. I have provided scholarly evidence that Jesus did die on the cross.
Okay, so what?
So what? It proves that when the Bible says something historically, it's accurate, sir, and you can trust it.
No, that's one fact. That is one fact that the Bible quotes. You can't therefore say that the rest of the Bible is therefore full of truth. I agree with you.
Are you an atheist?
Yes, I am.
Do you know who Michael Onfray is?
I don't care who he is. Answer my question. He died, so what?
Do you know who Michael Onfray is?
I don't care.
Michael Onfray is one of the greatest French philosophers today. Listen to this. He's one of the great, massive brains of the modern time. A great philosopher, and he is...
No,
Let me finish.
He said Jesus Christ died, so what?
Can I finish it?
I'm asking.
Michael Onfray is an atheist. Let me explain. Michael Onfray is one of the greatest philosophical minds.
He said somebody died.
Let me finish.
Why, so what?
Let me finish.
Go on.
He's an atheist. I'm going to explain. Michael Onfray is one of the great philosophical brains today. It is a French philosopher. Guess what? The greatest philosopher, one of the greatest philosophers in France, said that Jesus did not die. Now, in historical Jesus studies, when you study, a skeptic called Dominic Crossan, who doesn't believe the Bible, doesn't believe in what we believe, said that Jesus dying on the cross is one of the most well-attested facts in ancient history. Another atheist, Sam Harris, another atheist, Christopher Hitchens, another atheist, Richard Dawkins, they're not in touch in historical Jesus studies. Have you read their books, sir?
Not the Bible.
No, have you read Richard Dawkins' God Delusion? Have you read Christopher Hitchens' God Is Not Great? Have you read The End of Faith by Sam Harris? I've read them. Now, when you read their books, they are so bad at doing history, it's unbelievable. So here's the point. I would rather trust Luke, who says Jesus died, then Sam Harris is a poor historian.
Agreed. So what? Please answer my question.
So the point is, bro, I'm trusting the Bible, I ain't trusting your atheists.
No.
Honestly, guys,
they are not my atheists. I am an individual, I have an intellect, I have a brain. It's not brilliant, but I do have a brain. I choose to believe that maybe Jesus Christ did die on the cross. But thousands of people in history have died on the cross. What is the major significance of Jesus Christ dying on the cross?
Jesus said this.
So what? Jesus Please answer this. That question.
Jesus said this in Mark chapter 10. He said, I give my life a ransom for many. Right? He gave his life as a sacrifice for your sin. That's what.
Let me finish.
He died on that cross as a sacrifice for you. That's the big deal. He died as the Son of God for you, sir.
Did he want
so
you?
If you believe in him, and trust
you?
In him, and have faith in him, first of all, you've got to ditch these atheists because they're poor at history. And you need to start doing some proper research. And when you get to that, we can talk about theology, bro.
Did he want you to die?